Hello everybody, today we are going to see some problems which are depend on the cumulative frequency curve or an object. Okay, in the last period we have seen less than 10, today we are going to see more than 10. Understood? So today we have to solve this sum again in the notebook. Okay, so see carefully how to solve cumulative frequency curve or an object by more than 10. Understood? For that we have taken one example. See here. The frequency distribution of scores obtained by 230 candidates in a medical entrance test is as follows. Draw a cumulative frequency curve more than 10. Okay, this is the instruction given. Understood? What is given? Scores 400 and 450, 450 to 500, 500 to 550, 550 to 600, 600 to 650. 650 to 700, 700 to 750, 750 to 800, and the frequency is given, that is number of candidates is given, 20, 35, 40, 32, 24, 27, 18 and 35. Okay, so here intervals, if you observe here intervals are continuous, so no need to do any changes. Okay, so scores, as it is, we need to take 400 to 450, 450 to 500, 500 to 550, 550 to 600, 600 to 650, 650 to 700, 700 to 750, and 750 to 800. Okay, like that, the first scores will come as it is, the number of candidates, that is 20, 35, 40, 32, 24, 27, 80, then 34. Okay, so the number of candidates also as it is. Okay, now two more columns we need to prepare. That is, first one is score more than. Okay, more than is now more than 10. We are by more than 10 we are doing this. Okay, so more than is now we need to take the lower limit. Okay, so more than 400, then 400, 450, then 500, then 550, then 600, 650, 700 and 700. Okay, 700 and 700. More than 400 is what is going to come? Whole, all of this, sum of this all number of candidates from each interval. It will come, and that is given 230. So total is here, total of this is 230. So more than 400 all are going to come, and so sum of all the candidates is going to come. So here cumulative frequency, okay, more than that. Understood? So first one is going to come total sum, that is 230. Okay, then more than 450, more than 50 means sum of this all will come except this 20. So 20 we need to subtract from this. Understood? So 230 minus 20, it will be 210. Okay, now more than 500 means we need to subtract 35 plus 20. Okay, so 55 we need to subtract from the, what? 35 we need to subtract from 210. Understood? So 210 minus 35 will come 175. Okay, then after this more than 550 means sum of this all will come. Okay, or we can subtract 40 from this 170. Okay, so 175 minus 40 will be 135. Okay, then after that more than 600 means sum of this will come, or we can subtract 32 from 135. So 135 minus 32 will be 103. Okay, 103. Then more than 650, what is going to come? We need to subtract 27 from 103. So 27 from 103. 103 minus 27 will be 79. Okay, 79. Okay, now after this more than 700 become 18 we need to subtract from 17. 18 we need to subtract 1, 17. So 9 minus 8 is 1, 7 minus 1, 61. Okay. And last one is more than 750. More than 750 means we need to subtract 34 from 61. So 61 minus 34 we need to do. So that will come 27. Okay. So this is more than that, cumulative frequency. We have seen how to prepare more than that, cumulative frequency. Okay. So what we have done? More than 400. So whole addition will come here. Then more than 450. More than 50, 450 means this frequency we need to subtract from the total. Like that we need to go till the end. Okay. So this is we are going to put on the x axis. Okay. In less than 10 we have taken upper limit. And in more than 10 we are going to take lower limit on the x axis. And upper limit and this cumulative frequency on the y axis. Understood. So here according to this 400, 450, 500. This 400 is the smallest value. So we need to start from 400. Okay. So here suppose I will take 400, then I need to make here that end, because from 0 directly we are starting 400. So 400, then 450, then 500, then 550, then 600, then 650, then 700, 750, 800, and 850. Okay. 850, 700, 750 is enough. Okay. So this is on x-axis. X-axis is done. Now we need to think about y-axis. So here smallest is 27 and largest is 230. Okay. Largest is 230. So what we can do? We can start from 20. 20, 40, 60. So here 0. So here I will take 20. Then here 40. Then here 60. Then 80. Then 100, then 120, 140, 160, 180, 200, and 220, and 240. Okay, so 240, last one is 230. Okay, so just we need to plot the points. So first point is, if you want, you can write here 400, 230. Okay, then 450, 210, then 500, 175, then 550, 135, then 600, 603, then 650, 79, 761, so 750, 27. Okay, so these points we are going to plot. So 400 and 400, 230. 400 and 230. Okay, so 400 is here, 230. This will come exactly here. Okay, so this is the first 400 and 230. Then 450, 200, 210. 450, 210. So it will come here 220. 220, sorry, 230 will come here and 210 will come here. Okay, so it is going to come 210 here. Okay, then after this 500, 175, 500, 175, 180 and 160, 170 will come here. Okay, 500 is here, so 175 will come definitely in between this. Okay, then 550, 135, 550 and 135 is going to come in between 140, 120, 130. So here it will come. Okay. So 550. So that point is going to come here. Okay. 600, 103. 600 and 103. This is 100 is here. Okay. So 103 approximately it is going to come here. Then 650, 79. 650 and 79. 79 is 80 is here, 79 will come here. Okay, then 761, 700 and 61. 61 is here. Okay, 61. And 750, 27. 750 and 27. 27 means it is going to come, 30 is here. So little bit back. So these are the required points. So just we need to join with the three hands. Okay, so 750 is the last. Okay, so after this we can join. This is zero frequency. Okay, zero frequency 800 will have zero frequency. So we need to join. Got it, everybody? So this is the procedure to draw cumulative frequency curve for an object more than 10. Understood? In less than 10, we have taken lower limit. Okay, here upper limit in less than 10, and here we need to take lower. Understood? Frequency, cumulative frequency is more than 10 that we have seen. I have explained it. This is x coordinate, this is y coordinate, and just we have to put on the graph. Okay, so solve this example in your notebook. Okay, see here our next example. We are going to study about graph related to day-to-day activity. Understood? So this is the last point of preparation of graphs. Okay, so we will see this is what is given example. The table given below shows variation in the volume in centimeter cube of a certain mass of a gas at a certain temperature with change in pressure in mmHg. Draw a graph showing the relation between pressure and volume of a gas. Okay, so what is given? Pressure in mm and volume is given. This is given, and directly we need to put, we have to show this information on the graph. Okay, so directly we can plot those points. So I am taking this E. This we will show on x axis, and this we will show on the y axis. So our first plotting point is 1200, then 950, 210, then 900, 220, then 850, 850, 230, then 800, 250, 750, 260, and last one 700, 280. Okay, so this we need to show on the graph. Okay, so now this we are going to use for this pressure, we are going to use x axis. Okay, pressure we will show on the x axis. Okay, so if you observe here the readings, this is the largest and 700 is the smallest. Understood? So from 700 we can start. Okay, so this is, I am taking here 700, 700, then 750, then 800, then 850, then 900, 950, and 1000. Okay, so these are the points we have taken on the x axis. So here zigzag line is necessary because directly we have started from 700. So that thing is necessary. Now we will think about the y-axis. Y-axis is minimum is 200 and maximum is 280. So we can start from 200. So 200 I am taking here. 200. Suppose 200 will be, I am taking here 200. So now here also zigzag line is necessary because directly we are starting 200. Okay, so 200, then we can say we need last one 280. Okay, so what we can do, 200, either we can use 200, 210, 220, or 220 also directly. Okay, so here I am taking 200, then 210, then 220, 230, 240, 250, 260, 270, and 280. Okay, so this will we have taken the points of volume, okay, on the y-axis. Okay, so now first point is 1200. 1200. So 1000 is here and 200, this will come here. 1000 is here and 200 is here. So this is the first point. Then 950 and 200. 950 and 210. 950 and 210 is here. Then 900, 220. 900 and 220. 220 is here. Okay. Then 850, 230. 850 and 230. Okay. Then 800, 250. 800 is here. 800 and 250. 250 will be. 250 is here. Okay. So this is required. Then 750, 260. 750 and 260. 260 will be here. And last one 700, 280. 700 and 280. 280 is here. 700, 280. Okay. So just join with the freehand lines. Okay, and this is 1000, and last one, next one will be 1050. So this will be, we will join to the zero frequency. Understood? So this is the such type of graphs we use in the daily life. Understood? So this is our such type of one example we have seen. Examples are given in the worksheets. Solve the given worksheets. Okay. Here this was the last point of construction of graphs. Okay. Thank you very much.